Let's bring in Rakesh Arora, Managing Director and Head of Research at Macquarie Capital Securities India. Rakesh, good morning. Great to have you with us on the show as always. Prashant this side. A full 1 week has passed since that Euro summit, and also a week has passed, a little over a week has passed since Dr. Manmohan Singh took over the finance minister's job as well. Markets here rallied, global markets rallied, have given back about 50-60% of that rally, while the market here is largely holding on. Does this week sort of mark the start of some price drawdown here, Rakesh, or you still remain bullish?
See, we remain bullish because we are seeing some uptick happening in the infrastructure space. And, you know, that is getting reflected already in terms of cement demand or steel demand. Both has been growing close to around 9% or so in the last, 7-8 months. So there has been some uptick which is happening. Markets have probably, been factoring in a bit much more than what would possibly come in. We are not really hoping for any big bang reforms to happen, but it is largely the focus on debottlenecking and starting some of the projects on the ground to actually get executed is what is really making us bullish. So I think market would take a pause. We are getting into earnings season, and IT companies start this week. Our expectation is that they are going to cut their earnings growth forecasts. So that will set the tone, and also remember that rupee has depreciated, so most companies would be reporting forex losses. So I think all in all, I think markets need to consolidate and probably go down a bit before investors come back.
Okay, I mean, so you're not too worried about your earnings. You think most companies, because of the currency move, will report forex losses. But you remain bullish on the broader market because you think, some of the smaller stuff will happen. Administrative stuff, which basically frees up, maybe resources or pushes things forward in terms of infrastructure, etc. That's the way you're thinking about the market right now, Rakesh, right?
Yeah, that's how we are thinking about it. Meaning we are not worried about the underlying earnings. We think underlying earnings would be okay. But reported earnings would be, lower because of mark-to-market provisions which companies will have to do.
So, what's in your portfolio? What's in, what's out, Rakesh, right now?
Okay, so, we have reduced our overweight and actually gone underweight on IT because of two reasons. One, we think is that there are demand worries. And secondly, we thought that rupee had already, bottomed out. So those are the two reasons why we pushed IT to underweight. We are holding on to our overweights on, consumer discretionary, pharma, and we have actually gone overweight on industrials also. So these are our three key overweights. Apart from this, we are overweight on utilities, and we are maintaining our underweight on financials. Though we have cut it quite dramatically 2 quarters, but we think that the NPL cycle will peak out probably this quarter or next quarter, so there's still some more, downside there.
Right. So consumer discretionary is your bullish. I wanted to actually talk about that. Good that you brought it up. How worried are you that volumes will start to, taper off a little bit and throw in consumer staples into that as well? How worried are you that volumes will start to slow down?
There are some concerns because of deficient rainfall, and that is the only factor which can spoil the story. However, we think that historically we have seen that until and unless it is a drought year, normally demand doesn't get impacted as much. Even for a deficient rainfall, less than 10% of long period average, we need simultaneous 2-3 years before, demand can actually get impacted significantly. So for FY13, we are not too worried about, demand getting, beaten up. In fact, if I look at consensus estimates, they are forecasting revenue growth of just 10%, whereas the last 3-4 quarters, we have been closer to 20. And even this quarter, we are forecasting around 19% growth. So I would say that consensus is already factoring in a much lower growth scenario. And from the expectations where they are, we should see some positive surprises.
India's number one news app just got even better. Download NDTV's new app, fully optimized for retina display, full screen view, faster response time, and Sudoku. NDTV's new iPad app. Download now.